咁首先欢迎咁多位嚟今晚呢、這个CFA June 嘅即系2020 June 嘅 demo lecture 同埋info seminar。咁我系其中一位Kaplan 嘅CFA trainer James。咁咁我今晚会同大家 run 呢个 seminar 嘅。咁呢个 seminar 咧大致上会分，首先我介绍一下自己先。咁我其实咧就喺入，我谂系07年入行嘅。咁就一路入咗行之后就其实毕咗业之后就入行啦。咁一路都系喺investment field 里面做一啲analytic 嘅工作嘅，即系主要系啲股票同 fixed income 嘅research analyst 啦咁嘅 role 啦。咁就大致上都而家都系 enter 喺一个 family office 里面做紧一啲portfolio management 工作。咁我就系喺旧年就即系经过今年啦，今年就join 呢个 Kaplan 就同佢哋帮佢哋 run 帮手 run 呢个CFA level one 嘅 training。咁大致上就我嘅 background 就系主要系喺 asset management 方面啦。咁至於我哋今日呢我哋呢一個 seminar 嘅有分成三個部分嘅。咁首先我會好 brief 咁同大家講一講而家大致上個關於個 CFA program 啦，同埋關於而家個market trends 同埋究竟 CFA 呢一個qualification 會有乜嘢嘅即係應該話考咗 CFA 會有乜嘢嘅 career options 啦，同埋一啲potential 嘅 roles 嘅。咁另外第二部分咧就會係我嘅一個demo lecture。咁我抽咗其中一部分會同大家俾大家有個 quick taste about 即係我哋嚟緊個 education program 大致上會點 run， 同埋會係一個點樣嘅形式去進行啦。咁另外我嘅同事Chris 一陣間就會同大家會講翻一啲關於個education program， 即係同埋revision course， 即係一啲比較上一啲admin to logistic 嘅嘢，關於個 program， 即係啲 enrollment 嘅 info 會同大家分享翻嘅。咁好，我哋好快咁樣去講翻即係呢一個先。嗱，咁我諗呢一個即係關於 charter holders 嘅一啲 employers， 咁我好快跳一跳過啦。咁其實都主要係 mainly 嘅 charter holders 都會係效力一啲各大型嘅金融機構嘅。咁我自己本身就比較特別啲啦，咁我就我自己個 full time role 就係一啲family office， 咁就唔係 fall into 呢一啲嘅金融機構上面啦。咁但係大致上喺香港嘅 CFA 嘅 charter holders 呢大約7000幾位到，咁over 全個即係 globally 係10萬到啦。咁大部分都會係喺呢啲比較上大型嘅金融機構度效力嘅。咁我哋好 quickly 咁 group 同大家分析一下，究竟呢個通常 CFA charter holder 會係咩一啲喺咩嘅地方度做啦。咁我自己咧就一路以嚟咧都係比較上喺即係呢個，即係我哋叫 buy side。buy side 其實我哋點樣去分咧？就係buy side 就係一啲負責去 make investment decision 嘅角色 ，sell side 就係我哋會睇係一啲去 pitch 或者去 sell 一啲 securities 嘅一啲 roles 嚟嘅。咁呢個表咧其實就 summarize 咗大家唔同嘅有啲 sell side 同埋 buy side 嘅 roles 啊。咁我自己就個 background 就比較偏向 buy side 多啲，咁就係係一啲 portfolio management 幫個 office 去做一啲 investment decision 嘅。咁首先我自己開始嘅 career 咧就係按一個buy side analyst 啦。咁其實CFA program 對於我哋嚟講咧，其實就係一個俾咗一個 knowledge 俾我哋去有一個 framework 去做一個investment analysis 咁樣啦。咁另外咧，其實同樣道理咧，其實喺 sales 裏面咧都會有一個好大量嘅 demand for CFA charter holders， 特別係analyst 啊同埋 investment banking 呢啲咁嘅 roles 咧，其實都需要需要嗰啲人員咧係有一個好強嘅 analytical skills， 而CFA exam 本身係一個我哋話會係行內入邊一個比較上綜合性好強嘅 program， 去為俾大家有一個好強嘅即係 nurture 大家嘅 investment skills 嘅。咁當然啦，大部分嘅CFA charter holders 或者係考緊 CFA 嘅candidates 都會係喺 buy side 或者 sell side 嘅。咁當然有另外一啲 roles 都會係有charter holders， 特別係 corporate 裏面咧都會有自己 internal 嘅一啲corporate finance 啊，或者係一啲同 finance 有關嘅 roles， 佢哋都會 ask for CFA 嘅 charter holders 或者係 CFA 嘅 candidates 嘅。咁呢度我大致上講一講啦。咁其實主要請 CFA 嘅一啲機構咧，都會係一啲金融機構啦。咁呢度你會見到其實呢個可能有啲細啦。咁主要其實都係大銀行啊，或者係其他嘅金融機構啦。咁主要都會想大家會有一個 CFA 嘅qualification， 其實就係因為能夠呢、這個 program 會 make 俾 employers 一個 impression， 就係你有一個solid 嘅 knowledge in finance。咁主要係一個咁樣嘅 qualification 嚟嘅。咁呢啲我就可以快啲跳一跳先。咁呢個就另外一啲 even 你係唔係做 investment 嘅，其實而家喺其他嘅 division 咧都希望佢哋嘅 staff 有一個investment 嘅 knowledge， 特別係由於特別係譬如 compliance 或者 legal 呢啲咁嘅角色咧，其實佢哋都會接觸到好多唔同嘅 investment product 嘅。咁其實佢哋都會 expect 佢哋嘅employees 會知道關於一啲唔同嘅投資產品同埋佢哋一啲嘅特性。同埋點樣去做一個 valuation， 咁呢啲都會喺個 program 裏面，即係 CFA 呢個 program 裏面包含埋嘅。好，咁我哋嗱，咁呢度咧，有好多人都會問就係話，喺 CFA program 同其他一啲類似嘅 advanced 嘅 qualification 有咩分別呢？咁其實我呢、這個大家要留意嘅就係話 ，CFA program 本身咧，其實係一個考試嚟嘅啫，即係係一個 self study 嘅。咁當然啦，有其他唔同 training 啦，咁但係其實係 mainly on hard skill 嘅，即係我哋係會 develop 大家嘅一啲 solid 嘅關於 accounting、econ 同 finance 嘅 skill， 咁就唔會話其實對於 soft skills 嗰 part 嘅培訓咧，就俾即係其實就呢、這個 program 就唔係話係佢嘅 focus 嚟嘅，咁我哋會 focus 翻呢十個嘅areas。咁呢十個 areas 咧都會分別喺你嘅成個 CFA program， 即係有三個 levels 嘅 program 裏面咧，全部包含在內嘅。OK， 咁大家會有興趣知道嘅就係、是、我哋通常嘅 charter holders 會做嘅咩角色啦。咁呢個表就summarize 咗一啲比較 common 嘅角色。咁最大兩個 portion 嘅 CFA charter holders 其實都會係做 research 同埋做 portfolio management 嘅，咁其他嘅 roles 都會有，但係呢兩個係佢哋嘅佔多數啦。OK， 咁我哋 quickly 講一講究竟即係 CFA program 本身係一個咩嚟嘅？咁大致上個 program 咧我哋有三個 level 嘅考試，level one、level two 同 level three。咁我哋最主要係去學一啲 tools 同埋係 knowledge base 嘅，就唔係skill base， 即係冇啲比較上係我哋係考 hard skills 比較多嘅。OK， 咁要 enroll into CFA program 呢，第一個有幾個條件啦。第一個就係有個 bachelor degree 啦，或者其實你有四年嘅 full time 經驗就 OK 㗎啦。咁未必一定需要 investment related 嘅，咁或者 even 你係 final year 都可以 enroll into 呢個 CFA program。咁 once 你 enroll into level one program as a candidate 咧，咁你考咗 level one 之後咧，咁你就可以繼續去考 level two 同 level three 嘅。即係當然 provided that 你係 pass 咗呢個 program， 即係 pass 咗個 level one exam 啦。咁另外咧如果你想變成一個 charter holders 咧，咁第一有幾個條件嘅第一一定要考咗試先，即係 pass 個考試啦。sorry， 即係三個 level pass 曬，咁無限 attempt 嘅，即係你唔需要擔心我 fail 咗一次會唔會有影響？個答案係冇，你係可以無限 attempt 嘅。第二個就係無限時嘅，即係唔會話你考咗 level one 五年之內你要考曬 level two 或 level three， 冇呢咁嘅限制。As long as 你 pass 曬三個 level 就 OK 噶啦。咁另外一個重要嘅就係你要有四年嘅relevant work experience。嗱，呢度 relevant work experience 咧其實喺 CFA Institute 裏面咧係比較上個限制就比較少嘅。咁應該咁講，我哋話一般嚟講就係 investment related 啦，咁但係會好多大家都會好多話啊，譬如我做accounting 啊，或者係我做一啲 有啲 finance related 嘅嘢，咁係咪就唔係 relevant work experience 呢？咁呢個我哋喺度就會係以一個 case by case 嘅 basis， 同埋其實喺呢，我會 advise 大家就係話，重點係如果你想做 chart， 即係如果想攞 chart holder 嘅話呢，重點係 pass 嗰三個考試。個 work experience 呢嗰度可以有，即係我哋可以有啲 room for massage 嘅。咁另外一樣嘢就係要有兩個 existing 嘅 charter holder 做你嘅 sponsor， 即係佢要肯簽名做你嘅即係 sponsor 啦，咁先至會做到charter holder。咁你先可以即係 technically 就係你可以喺呢個name card 度掛住你係CFA 啦。咁另外一樣嘢就係如果你要做即係 maintain 個 charter holder 嘅話呢，咁就要交會費同埋 maintain as 一個 regular member 啦。OK， 好，呢、這個會大家比較關心啲嘅，就係究竟我哋 CFA 考試考啲乜？咁由於大家 focus 嘅係 level one 啦，咁呢一個就會係嚟緊2020年嘅個 breakdown 嚟嘅。咁其實呢你會見到無論係 level one、level two 同 level three 都好啦，我哋都會擺好多時間喺即係好多俾一個 significant portion 係喺 ethics 嘅。Ethics 同 professional standard 呢個係CFA initiative 會好重視嘅。另外其他你見到呢啲嘅 areas 咧，其實都係一啲 hard knowledge 嚟嘅，即係無論係econ、financial reporting 即係 accounting 啦、corporate finance 呢啲都其實係同一個 finance degree 有類似嘅你需要知道嘅 knowledge 啊。咁其實level one 嘅考試嘅內個 depth 咧，就同大約係同一個 finance degree 學嘅嘢差唔多，應該係有多冇少嘅。咁而 level two 就會比較上係都係會考翻同樣嘅嘢。咁呢個我哋可以喺即係之後大家pass 咗 level one 之後咧，我哋可以即係再睇翻啦。咁 OK， 咁另外咧考試嘅形式咧係我哋全部都係用 multiple choice 去考試嘅。咁120条上昼 ,120 条下昼，我哋考一日嘅3加 3， 即係3个钟头再加3个钟头。咁一共係240条 multiple choice。咁另外就大家如果諗住 enroll into 一个考试呢而想搵 pass paper 嘅话呢，咁大家可以寫一条心啦。係冇嘅。係冇 pass， 即係冇 official 嘅 pass paper 嘅。咁另外呢我哋無論係朝頭早或者係下晝嘅 section 咧，都會係 cover 曬所有嘅 topics 嘅，即係唔存在話考完一啲 topic 下晝就唔考咁樣嘅，冇呢啲咁嘅情況啦。咁另外呢一個大家都會關心嘅就係嗰個 passing rate。咁我哋其實 on average 咧，你會預個 passing rate 係40-45% 度啦 ，for level one。咁所以其實咧就個 hurdle 都唔容易嘅，需要大家即係要花一定嘅時間去做一個即係 study 啦。咁另外呢有一樣，另外一個我哋係冇 minimum passing score 嘅，唯一就係話我哋 officially 呢，如果你 score 70%以上嘅話呢，即係啱曬啱70%樓上嘅題目嘅話呢，咁就未 fail 過你。咁但係係咪代表個 cut off 係 70% 呢？唔係，應唔 exactly 70% 嘅，即係話你大約係 slightly lower 都可能有機會 pass 嘅。如果 in an absolute grade 嘅 level 嚟講，好咁我哋嗱，咁我哋頭先講過啦，大約個考試分成三個 level 啦。咁 level one 最主要嘅係一啲 hard knowledge 嚟嘅，無論係關於 finance 啊、econ 啊、accounting， 全部都係比較上係 hard knowledge 嘅一個test 嚟嘅。咁對於大家嚟講咧，最大嘅挑戰咧係個量，因為咧而且大家見到咧。呢、這個如果你 enroll to 個 program 咧，呢一個係 CFA Institute send 俾大家嘅嗰、那個official 嘅 reading material。咁呢個你可以而家個你會見有 ebook 嘅，而你可以 request for hard copy， 咁就大約係咁厚啦。咁我哋嘅training material 咧就係、是、左手邊嗰啲。咁大致上就會係 summarize 咗reading material 上面嘅嘢。咁無論係睇我哋嘅 training material 或者係 official 嘅 reading 啦。咁其實個量都係一個好大嘅挑戰嚟嘅，即係要每一個 topic 都要大家有一個一定嘅 knowledge 啦。OK， 咁另外咧呢度都講過啦，就係話個量係即係呢個量比較多啦，咁同埋個 topic 係 cross topic 嘅。咁大家要留意嘅就係、是、啲名嘅 concept 係非常之重要嘅。好，咁另外咧呢度咧我哋就簡單介紹一下呢個我哋個 program， 即係 Kaplan 呢個 CFA training 嘅 program 有三個部分啦。咁我哋第一個咧就係、是、講 education program 啦。education program 咧就係俾一啲即係我哋大約會係60個鐘，咁就60個鐘裏面咧，我哋就會 cover 曬所有要考嘅 area。咁呢度咧就會係俾大家有一個basic knowledge on 呢啲 topics 嘅。咁另外咧revision class 我哋就會主要係 focus 一啲problem solving， 我哋會用一啲question bank 嘅題目或者係一啲tricky 嘅題目。我哋 trainer 會pick up 一啲 tricky 嘅題目啦，或者係一啲common mistake 嘅題目啦，咁我就幫大家去喺考試之前咧做一個 quick review。咁最後就係 mock exam， mock exam 就係、是、其實就 simulate 真實嘅考試環境，咁然後可以俾大家有一個喺考試之前，呢、這個就會係一般嚟講，我哋就會喺考試之前嘅兩個星期去進行嘅，咁我哋會有一個 section， 咁就會做呢啲嘅 review 啦。咁另外咧，係啦，咁另外就我哋一般嚟講 ，education program 咧就會係除咗係有我哋嘅 slice pack 之外咧，咁另外我哋主要喺 education program 裏面咧就會係同大家 go through 翻啲 concept 啦，同埋有一個 progress test 俾大家去做一個 recap 嘅。咁另外呢其實最主要就係話 education program 呢主要係希望幫大家慳返啲時間去做一個即係唔使睇咁即係唔使睇嗰個 reading material 睇得咁多嘅，因為我哋希望就係盡量喺個 education program 度 highlight 一啲 key points 俾大家知道究竟嗰個 topic 需要注意嘅一啲內容啦。咁另外 revision class 就會係講返一啲難題啦，咁另外就係 mock exam 啦，咁呢度係啦。咁好，咁我哋呢今日我就去到我哋呢一个 section 嘅第二部分，就会系一个简短嘅 demo lecture 嚟嘅。咁呢个 lecture 呢我哋嘅形式就会系 similar 一个我哋做 education program 嘅时候嘅一个 environment 嚟嘅。咁我今咁首先我哋都做少少 highlight 啦，咁关于我哋个即係呢個 education program 裏面咧嘅 materials 嘅，咁主要咧我哋 education program 嘅 material 咧，咁係可以一個 slice pack 嘅形式俾大家啦。咁呢個 slice pack 咧，主要係一啲我哋 Kaplan 自己會summarize 咗 reading 上面一啲比較重要嘅 material 啦，同埋一啲重要嘅 example 嘅。咁我哋都會有一個即係每一個 slice 都會有一個 reference to 翻相關嘅 readings 同埋相關嘅 learning objectives。咁我哋大致上成個 program 會有40幾個 learning objective statement， 即係有40幾個 item 要大家要知道嘅。咁我哋都即係啲 slides 裏面呢我哋都會有一個 reference 俾大家可以參考返相關嘅readings， 或者係相關我哋一啲其他嘅 supporting material 嘅位置嘅。咁今日我呢、這個短嘅 demo lecture 呢主要 focus 係 on 呢個 quantitative method， 咁同埋係想同大家分享返我哋點樣去 understand 呢、這個basic probabilities 嘅。Okay， 好，咁首先呢我就為大家做一個好簡單嘅簡介啦，關於 probability。咁其實呢首先我哋喺成個呢個 program 裏面呢大家會認為 probability 呢好多都係即係雖然 quantitative method 啦，咁好多時候以為都係計數嘅，其實唔係嘅。其實好多時喺個考試裏面呢係 concept 同埋計數呢係各佔大約係5:5嘅。即係 even 我哋呢啲 terms terminology 呢其實個考試都會有考到嘅。嗱我哋留意啦譬如我哋喺 probability 裏面呢其實佢都會 ask for 一啲大家要知道一啲terms 啦，譬如我哋要知道咩叫做 random number，random variable，sorry，random variable 其實就係去 describe 一個我哋用一個 unknown 去 describe 一啲uncertain 嘅數字嘅。咁例如即係話我哋譬如 say 我摘粒骰仔，我個 outcome 可以係1到6，咁我哋會用呢個 random variable 去 describe 呢個 outcome 嘅。咁嗱，另外咧，譬如我哋另外有時候會都要知道咩叫做我哋會 describe 一啲 events 啦，譬如即係其實就係講緊一啲唔同嘅 outcomes， 即係譬如我哋擲骰仔咁樣，我哋有1至6。咁另外 mutually exclusive 呢啲 terms 咧，其實大家都要留意啦。例如mutually exclusive outcome 咧，就係話一啲 outcome 我哋係冇唔可以同時發生嘅。好嗱，另外一樣我哋需要 highlight 嘅一啲 probability 嘅 concept 咧，就係一個好重要嘅 concept， 關於 probability 嘅。probability 咧係唔可以係負數嘅。OK， 我哋要知道唔可以負數啦。另外我哋亦都知道咧 ，probability 咧係唔可以超過一嘅，即係話我哋一嘅意思咧，其實就即係 100% sure， 你一定會發生就係 100%。OK， 另外呢我哋亦都要留意下，就係話所有嘅 probability 加埋其實就會係等於 100%。 好似用返我哋頭先呢個擲骰仔嘅例子啦，我哋擲粒骰，一我哋有六個 possible outcome， 一到六啦，我哋呢啲呢個呢啲 outcome 嘅 probability 加埋呢一定要係 100% 嘅，一定會係包含晒所有會發生嘅事啦。好另外呢度呢，除咗我哋要知道一啲歸 basic concept on probability 之外呢，另外我哋都要 describe 點樣去 describe probability。 咁有喺個 curriculum 裏面呢，我哋有三個唔同嘅probability 嘅 concept 要知道嘅。第一個係所謂嘅 empirical probability， 其實 empirical 嘅意思就係我哋根據過去嘅一啲information， 例如我睇過去100日個股市有幾多日升，有幾多日跌，咁呢個係我哋，然後我哋去估算究竟有幾個股市裏個股票市場有幾多個 probability 係升，有幾多個 probability 係跌，咁我哋基於一啲過去嘅 data 嘅，咁而 subjective probability 咧就係你自己嘅主觀判斷，即係譬如我話我覺得聽日個市七成有機會，個股票市場聽日嘅恆指有七成機會會升，呢個係我 based on 我自己嘅個人觀感、主觀意見。咁呢個叫做喺我哋叫做 subjective probability， 而呢個最後呢個咧 priority probability 咧，其實就係根據一啲mathematical model 或者係數學嘅分析去做嘅一啲probability。例如我哋擲骰仔，我哋點解會知道粒骰仔 turn out 我哋見到一嘅機會係六分之一，係因為我哋 assume 緊粒骰係一個 fair dice， 因為有六個面，我哋知道應該係有一個even 嘅 outcome 嘅，即係大家係一個 equal 嘅 chance， 我見到每一個面嘅。咁呢個係 based on 一啲 mathematical 嘅 reasoning。咁呢啲都係會喺probability 嘅 concept 裏面呢要大家明白嘅。OK， 另外呢關於 probability 呢喺都需要大家知道一個新嘅 concept 啦。呢個 concept 呢就喺相信就會比較少見啲，就係關於 odds 嘅。因為呢我哋喺 investment 嘅世界裏面呢，好多時都想 assess 究竟我哋個chance of winning versus 個 chance of losing 嘅。咁其實有少少似喺賭場賭錢啦。咁odds for 呢就係話我贏嘅機會，贏對輸嘅機會， win to lose。odds against 呢就係 lose to win。我哋好簡單地將個 cases 呢，即係將個我哋一個 bet 分成 win or lose 嘅啫。我哋好簡單地去將佢做一個二分。譬如我去賭馬，咁我 bet 隻馬會唔會跑第一，咁呢個係一個win lose situation， 我一係隻馬跑第一，一係唔係嘅啫。咁我哋就會話我哋想 bet 究竟所謂嘅 odds for 咧，其實就係究竟我 win 嘅 chance to 我 lose 嘅 chance 係幾多？咁呢個 concept 咧，其實對於我哋嚟講咧，我哋就會去計究竟我願意用幾多錢去 risk 呢個 bet。咁呢個會喺之後我哋會講portfolio management 裏面咧，我哋會應用到呢一個 concept 嘅。好，我哋咧另外一個需要知道嘅咧就係conditional 同 unconditional probability 啦。咁 conditional probability 咧，其實就係話一啲嗱，我哋簡單嚟講。如果我知道，譬如啦，我知道 say 呢個 HSBC 會出呢、這個嚟緊今晚會出 earnings， for example， 如果我知道 given HSBC 個 earnings 係靚仔嘅話，即係係做得好嘅話，咁恆指聽日升嘅機會係幾多？咁呢一個就係我哋所謂嘅 conditional probability， 我哋知道一啲 information， 然後我哋去 assess 個 probability of 一個 event。而如果係 unconditional 嘅話咧，就係我就咁去 assess 究竟個恆生指數聽日會升嘅機會係幾多，冇任何嘅 information 知道嘅。OK， 咁呢個就係 conditional probability 同 unconditional probability 之間嘅分別啦。咁呢度呢就我哋都 quickly highlight 返一啲probability 嘅 rules 啦。咁呢個 rules 呢其實就我哋要用一個所謂嘅 Venn diagram 去 understand 呢件事嘅。嗱，我哋有 event A 同 event B。咁我哋點去理解呢？ A 或 B 發生嘅機會呢其實就係兩個綠色發生嘅。即係我哋綠色 highlight 咗呢一部分啦。咁而點樣去 understand 呢個 equation 呢，有呢三個 probability 嘅。咁我哋咁樣睇。我哋用唔同嘅 color 去 understand 呢個 program。sorry, 呢個 equation。OK。首先如果係 probability A 呢，其實就係我黃色 highlight 咗嗰啲。而 probability B 呢就是我哋蓝色 highlight 咗嘅部分。嗱，你见到呢我哋中间呢度呢，如果我哋 count 嘅时候呢，我哋 count 咗两次嘅。因为重叠咗连续 count 咗两次嘛。但係我哋计 A 或 B 绿色呢个部分嘅时候呢，其实我哋只需要将呢部分、中间呢部分同埋蓝色呢部分三个加埋嘅啫。咁因为我哋呢度呢、中间呢度呢 count 咗中间嗰 part 两次，所以喺度我哋要減返佢。我哋咁去理解呢、這、一个formula。咁其他嘅 formula 呢，咁我哋可以喺即係呢度呢我哋暂时就做一个简单嘅介绍啦。咁另外其他嘅 formula 我哋之后都会再讲嘅。好，咁后面呢啲呢我哋就由于今日个 seminar 比较短啦，咁呢个就我哋会skip 咗佢。好，咁我哋呢好，咁大家有冇咩关于呢个新係，咁大家有冇咩关于个 program 或关于个outcome 有冇啲咩问题想知道㗎？即係關於嚟緊考2020咁2020個 program 呢就同2019 DEC 個 program 如果有嘅改動呢，大約佔咗成個 curriculum 嘅 5% 到嘅。咁就會係主要會係改動嘅嘢，主要係喺 financial analysis， 即係 financial reporting analysis 同埋 derivative 都會有一啲 reading 上嘅改動。咁而個暫時嚟講就冇任何新加嘅 material。咁即係話2019考嘅嘢呢 ,2020 都會繼續考嘅。咁個主要個轉變係喺 financial reporting 度。如果即係大家係即係之前考過，喺2020諗住會再 reattempt 嘅話呢，咁呢個就大家可以留意一下嘅轉變。即係如果當然啦 ,first attempt 對於大家就冇影響啦，因為之前考嘅嘢其實就唔係好關大家事嘅。